trying to go natural.
Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. I decided to come on and just do a quick review of a couple of products I tried. So I finally tried this Tre Naturals brand. So I've had it for a while, as you know. I also got a conditioning bar from this brand, which I do still want to try, but I didn't have labeling. See that video. And I was just like, whatever. Been kind of busy and lazy these days, so I decided to just try these two. So here I am with a quick review on how they worked for me. So I have it in my hair now. I did put some Uncle Funky's Daughter Curly Magic Gel over this. But basically, I used this deep conditioner, then I used this spray leave-in, and then I used the Uncle Funky Curly Magic. Overall, I guess I would rate these products as okay. This one was moisturizing, but the slip was definitely not there. Like, there wasn't enough slip really to work it through my hair. I had to just get very carefully, get it on and work it through, but I would say that the slip was very subpar. But it did moisturize my hair. Wasn't like immediate moisture, but after that slip for half an hour, my hair was moisturized. And it does smell amazing as well. So give it an A for scent, A for texture, C for slip, and B plus or something for moisture. It has a nice kind of spa scent. It smells almost like soap, like bar soap, really nice smelling bar soap. It doesn't smell like edible at all, which is like a typical scent that you get, I guess, in hair products a lot, edible or perfume. It is, you can see a little bit here. So it's not super thick, but it's not super light either. So I do like the texture as well. I just wish it had more slip, but everything else worked out pretty well. So these are the ingredients. And I found these in a natural hair show. I went to a good few natural hair shows last year. I don't think I'm going to any this year just because I have too much stuff. Don't know if I mentioned that to you yet, but I have too much stuff, really do. So yeah, I'm definitely on a no-buy pretty much this year. Except for Black Friday, of course, and even Black Friday may be reduced from usual. But this is one of those, I think it's a kind of local brand in the sense that I think the company's in Virginia or something, but in the DMV, DC area. I like the labeling, and then the bamboo fig and lotus flower did kind of have me interested when I bought this, which was like, actually, I have to tell you how long ago, but it was like 2 years ago I think I bought this, and at that time these ingredients looked really interesting. Overall, it was a nice product, just not like as good as, like she said, you know, like the typical deep conditioners that I use, but it definitely got the job done. And you know, if I had to reach for this, I wouldn't be too sad about it. I just make sure I detangle first, pretty much. But I'll be confident that my hair will be moisturized at the end, which is kind of the main point of a deep conditioner. I also love the labeling, I have to say that for it. I really love the labeling as well. I just like the whole vibe of it. Like, relax your mind and escape with this freshly scented pamper party for your curls. Yeah, I like the sound of that. So I like her labeling and I like her vibe. Black owned, which is good as well. The hair milk, I have to say, was better overall as a product than the deep conditioner because it was moisturizing and it had decent slip. So the slip wasn't crazy, but the slip was definitely good enough to get it onto my hair easily. And it was more moisturizing and more creamy. I guess I can just show you, but you see, like, it is pretty much, you know, creamy. I didn't have to worry about it being like a spray or something. It is very light, but it is also very creamy. And I definitely did leave-in things for my hair. Like, I had another leave-in on standby in case it didn't work out, but this was enough of a leave-in for me to use confidently. I just used this leave-in and then went on to the Uncle Funky Sort of Curly Magic, and my hair is moisturized and everything is fine. The leave-in is definitely a nice product that I can safely recommend if you're looking for like a spray leave-in or like a lighter leave-in. Of course, it doesn't go on as a spray like you saw. It is pretty thick, but it's definitely not lotion thick. Is in the lighter leave-in section. I prefer this to the Caravana similar situation type spritz leave-in because this one was thicker, like richer, like more of a leave-in and had better slip and was also moisturizing, if not more moisturizing. Yeah, this has a similar scent to the deep conditioner, that kind of dove-ish, kind of bath soap-ish spa type scent. So I do like the scent of these, and I like that I don't get these scents in a lot of other brands, so I guess it's kind of unique for the scent. So if you like something sweet but soapy, not edible, then this would be a nice try as well. So these are the ingredients. Of course, it's not vegan, I guess, because it has honey in it, but I like my hair likes honey, so we good with that. nice ingredients, nice scent, did the leave-in thing. So overall, I like this. So this product, I'd probably give it like a 7.5. 8 out of 10. This I'll probably give like a 6.5 out of 10. I do have it in my hair right now, like I said, and you know, my hair feels great and it feels moisturized. This is like a multi-day as well, so it has gotten, I have had a few days to make sure it's not getting dry or anything, and it really does feel nice. So definitely a win on moisture. I still like to, like, if I come across a small business and the ingredients look interesting, I still like to give them a try. So that's it, coming in with a quick review. Have you tried these before? Have you tried this brand before? I guess let me know. Let me know what you've been trying lately, what hair products you've been trying lately, and what you think of them in the comments below. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.